Pencil on blank paper. Something like that, yeah. Gnome-vember. I was, don't even know if I want to bring it up. Gnomes. What are you up to? I got your stuff shipped off today, finally. You and a couple others. It's like, yay! Hey, thanks for the follow. Holy crap, a raid. What the heck? Hey, what's happening? Happy Saturday. We're here, High Expectations. Now, how's your weekend going? I'm going good. How's everybody's weekend going? Man. What the heck? Just getting started. I don't even know what I'm doing. Where the modern art hangs out. Red. Oh man.
Let's go.
Make good art. Just fly into it. I'd say no pressure, but it seems like pressure. Thanks for the stream. Oh man. Red's awesome. Just in case no one's seen it, I'm giving away these things tomorrow. I've got three of these skull knights. If you go over to my Twitter or Instagram, I've got a post on there where you can just comment or something like that, and that's enough. You'll be in, and I'll pick from a random. I've got like 50 people now across all the places. Still pretty good odds of snagging one if you want one. Ink, watercolor, gouache. More cat peoples. Yes, that was a good one that people seemed to like. It's not gone yet. I didn't give. It's still here. But it's already purchased. Someone sold it. I have to hand deliver it. Yeah, I should do more cat people. Yeah. That's that. Giveaway, is it one specific for each platform or it's everything all together? Like, I'm just putting all the people that participate together because I don't have I have like 10 people on each at each place, and so I'm just putting it all together. And yeah, I think Instagram has like a bigger group of people, like 30 people who commented or something, or I don't I've written them down, but it's really just simple. Yes, on Instagram, just comment on that post or whatever. Funny thing, I actually accidentally tonight made a mistake on Twitter and tried to retweet it, and I deleted it like a freaking idiot. But I'd already written everybody's name down, so I just like retweeted the other. I was like, anybody wants to be involved on Twitter for this for the next day? I'd already written everybody down, though. So, yeah, I'm an idiot. I'm going to start learning how to do stuff. All right, so what do we have here? Getting crazy. Let's just go nuts. I don't know. This face. Yeah, what are you guys up to? Were you just doing video game stuff, Red? I don't know if you're still here. finish this quick. Still doing. He worked on the nights after dinner. Ah, cool. Doing the night stuff. Cleaning up my brushes. Oh, that's right. You're gonna get into some minis. Do those cheap brushes show up on you? Told me you told everyone that lie I read. The only trash in your stream are my troll comments. Dancing gnome? Yeah, he's hopping over something, I don't know what. it's November, Gnome-vember, supposedly. So I was like, I don't know what to draw. I'll draw a little gnome guy. Thanks for the follow, decaf mage. Blue Skittle. I need to lurk and get some things done. Nice to meet you. Hey, thanks, Avocado Kids. Find a place to hibernate. Have a good stream and evening. Absolutely, the real bear manator. Thanks for stopping in with Red. This guy like so fast. I was all like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I didn't stream last night for the same reason. I'm like, I don't really know. I was just tired also. I was like, oh shit. Just come on, sketch anything. Be like, gnomes? I can do gnomes. No problem. The giveaway on the rate? I did. Thanks, Matt. Cryptids even in here? What are you up to, Cryptid? Man, I shut up encrypted stream the other day. And he like instantly called out all of my stuff and gave me a shout out. I was like, what the heck? Wasn't expecting that. It's freaking cool. I need to be more, I wish I could be more set up for being able to do stuff like that. Because I'm like, my drawing table and facing away from the computer. Be able to jump on it real quick and show people. Follow this guy. Because that was awesome. Cryptiv is amazing. Yeah, amazingly supportive. It's a cool way to be. I want to be that way. Am I going to stop and turn around and figure out how to do that right now? No, probably not. Not as cool. Not as cool as cryptid. Also, while your drawing is very neat, I'm envious. It can be, and then it can be kind of a mess. A lot. A really, really big mess. It's like, sometimes I just go for it. I'm just like, bam. Hey, it's not so bad. I think the trying to maintain it for painting, it can be good and bad. It can be like, it could be like a mess, and it really comes out when I add paint to it. Sort of like a comic book penciler. When you see the pencils, you're like, this looks like a bowl of oatmeal. I can't tell what's happening. But then the ink and then the color comes along, you're like, oh, now I can kind of see what it is. I feel like it's the same vein, but that might also be me allowing it to be not quite a clean drawing. That's what it is. I'm glad more people are watching this stream. It's hit or miss. I have an amazing group of people that I tapped into, luckily, with Red Jar Jam. And he just happened to be, I stream like when he finishes his stream, and he's been jumping over every now and then, which is freaking awesome. So I get a little boost. We'll get a little red boost. And there's been a few others like that. So that's been awesome. It's been very, very fortunate. It makes the stream a little more entertaining. Tonight I'm going along 28 minutes and already going to start coloring. 22. Thanks for the follow. What are you up to tonight, Rico? You having a lovely evening? Remembered how I was going to order the fountain pens you have before I went to Japan to take them with me. However, the pens never came, and I got a refund. Oh. Oh, you were getting that, the Duke? The silver guy? Guy's cool. Yep. What am I doing? Where am I at? Gloves. Not that color. All right. Oh well. We'll go with it. You know, I didn't mind this process of Inktober. I wasn't drawing like this before Inktober, doing like a drawing and then painting it quick, but I kind of liked as far as the stream is concerned, I'm like, hey, it kind of worked out sometimes, even though I like to just straight paint like my last stream. It's like kind of handy to be able to just draw something, paint on it. It's pretty awesome. 22, thanks for the sub. Prime sub. It's a bummer you couldn't get them. Thank you. Yes, my first flight is this Tuesday. I hope I can get them in. Or it's not going to get there. If I do find some, I'll buy a couple for sure. Yeah, they're pretty cool. It comes with like a refill thing, so one should be good for a while. But oh, and then I got, I don't know if you're talking about other fountain pens or just that one, but what color should I make this guy? Crap, he's got red on him. Should I make it? Shoot. I know. I'll make this thing red. Blues and teals. Yeah, that's actually, I'm gonna leave this red. These two things, they're kind of reddish. The only red, and I was gonna put blues and teals. Look at you, Tammond. Yeah, that was my idea. I was gonna do that already. I wanna see if I can find different. There's a million fountain pens, man. There's so many good ones. So many good fountain pens. I like got into it and I was like, what did I just get into? This is like a whole lifestyle for people. It's a whole thing. I like that and hate it when I fall into those things. I'm like, oh, so this is like some people's lives. Yeah, red was like, good luck with all that. I was like casually mentioning, like, hey, I'm looking at getting into that. He's like, psh. Slap. Oh, that makes green. Why did I do that? I don't want green. Blue green. That place looks pretty cool. Not looks, it is really cool. It's like, whoa. Like if you're serious about pins. About pins, come to Goulet Pins. And he showed me that place after I had already purchased a whole 15-year bottle of one type of ink. And they have samples. Little sample packets that I could have gotten for like $5 or something. I don't know. No, I want 30 years of this one red that I'll probably never use very often. It looks cool in a little thing I seen. Yeah, the little samples. That's exactly what I. But at that point, I was already like, well, too late. It's like, you could send that back. Nah. Yeah. I might try to sell that bottle, actually. I used, filled it up once. Not to try new inks, but to deal with the fact that I bought this freaking mess. It was like, yeah, I could resell this, I guess. It's like $15 or something. No, I'll buy the samples from moving forward, but it was just dealing with this one. I was fine with this Noodler's Black. I'm fine with this one. Because it works well enough. It doesn't work that well. I kind of don't like it, but oh well. I'm dealing with it. Asked this, but who has been your main inspiration or influence during your art career? I have a whole bunch of people from time to time. When I went from, I used to just do black and white stuff all the way up and through college. And after college, I got into digital painting through people on conceptart.org. And it was this guy, Dave Raposa, and a handful of other artists that were kind of, they were going crazy learning how to digital paint. So that was a huge one, and that got me into painting and color and everything. But overall, Brian Froud, he has like this fairies book. Brian Froud and Alan Lee have this fairies book, and Paul Bonner, he works for Games Workshop, but he does all these watercolor fantasy art paintings that are just freaking amazing, that I love. They're kind of obscure, but anyways, that's basically it. I mean, there's so many, right? Like, I get, you get hyped every like 5 years on new people. Those are the consistent that I go back to, is those like Brian Froud, Alan Lee book, Brian Froud stuff. Brian Froud did all the concept art for like Labyrinth and the Dark Crystal and whatnot. I just like that weird fantasy stuff from the 70s or 80s. The concept art years, when I first started digital painting though, or teaching myself to paint, it was just those forms were so cool, because it was like you could see they were just doing so, it was like a handful of them, these guys that were just doing so much studies. It would be like 1,000 hands a week, and you'd see them go from like not being able to paint and draw very well to like crazy stuff in such a short, it was like all in these little forums, sketchbook forums. Yeah, Henrik Rosenberg is a Bonner, like Bonner baby. He's like carrying the mantle of like the closest to a Bonner fan. Like, there's so many Frazetta dudes like that. He's like the closest Bonner lookalike kind of guy. He's freaking awesome. Dude's awesome. He definitely has his own thing, not to be like, he just, but yeah, he's definitely going for that Bonner kind of a creative push. Kind of wild with the shapes and such. I love that stuff. Yeah, basically, I just realized like how I said it. I was like, yeah, he's biting on Bonner. Like, I mean, you can tell the influences though. I'm like, especially it's close to home because it's a person who loves Paul Bonner as well. It's like you can tell. You're like, oh, this guy. Also, I think they're like live near each other. Like both living in Sweden or something. I mean, how could you not? If you got what other massive influence is Miyazaki movies? I freaking love those things like too much. Like I love them too much. Like, I can't be trusted. I like him so much, I can't be trusted. Like, fan. Super fan. It's like when you watch something, and the whole time you're just going, genius. This guy's genius. For like the 100th time you've rewatched something, you know you've got like a problem. This guy's just... it's just amazing. See someone else enjoying it. No, you don't know why this is so amazing. Like, do you see what he's doing here? It's freaking brilliant. In fact, it's so bad with the Miyazaki movies. The more I watch stuff, even the ones I don't like, turn into the ones I like even more. It's like a it's just forever, like, fractal obsession of just rolling. It's like, oh yeah, and now this. Oh man, I never even saw it from this way, dude. Used to only be able to go to sleep with one on the TV playing. I was trying to stay away from Porco Rosso, ended up loving it. And I love the dubs too. I'm like, oh man, I like even the people they chose to the voiceovers and stuff. And I wanted to like not. You know, it's like the way to be, to like be all respect the original voice. I'm like, nah, I love it. I love it. They've got freaking what's his name? Batman himself is Porco Rosso. Old Batman. And the new Batman is Hal. It was great. Yeah, Keaton was so good. I loved it. I'm like, Keaton's great. Then again, I like Keaton, so. Yeah, Porco Rosso was like a sleeper. This is dorky. Even reading Miyazaki's books, he was saying how he he thought that Porco Rosso was his most like self-indulgent thing, a film he shouldn't have made. I'm like, whatever. That freaking stuff was great. I loved it. Then again, do you think that'll ever happen? Where a studio is just like, we don't know where you're getting ideas from, and you didn't even pitch to us a full idea. Just go ahead and go. Like, we'll start production. Just whatever you got on the storyboard this week, that's what we'll work on. Do you think that can it ever happen at a studio scale, like a movie scale? It's like, that'll never happen ever, ever, ever again. Where a whole studio was like, yep, we don't even know what this story is, but we're working on it. Like, I don't see that happening. Where the production team, the marketing, nobody even knows what this is. Like, what is it? What's going on? Half the team has no clue. My Neighbor Totoro Studio Ghibli dubs ruins it. Movie for me. The Fox dub has been judging the movie the whole way through. I don't know exactly. My Neighbor Totoro, I didn't really notice the, like, that wouldn't bother me too much. It's just unremarkable, basically, the vocal, the performances or whatever, but the rest of the movie is just so good. Hey, all, what's happening? What are you up to this fine evening? Happy Saturday. Yeah, happy art day. Art's coming together. The Christmas lights, man. Christmas is here. Alright, yeah. There's Christmas radio playing in my house. Or there was already. And I was like, what? I don't have a hate for it, but it's definitely like, come on. Already? Let the turkey have his holiday. Really? That's right. That's what I'm saying. I like Thanksgiving. Then again, I just don't really care. It's all fine. People, man. You gotta let people do their thing. I'm into some dorky stuff. What do I care? Listen to that holiday music. Go for it. Thanksgiving is in October. I should have made this dude's gloves red, but I made a mistake. It would stand out better if it was like this red. That's alright. Oh, painting. I'm half Japanese and half Mexican, but raised in the USA, so I'm all over the place. So you have like, what's the more overriding culture? Raised in the United States. So that's what it is. It's US culture, right? Unless your family's super strong. Yeah, everybody's different, so who knows? What's the overriding culture of the bunch that you'd follow all the... that your family follows all the stuff? Cannot say too long, but I've... identified that mechanical pencil. Yeah. Graph gear is my favorite. I like 0.3. And then this is just dollar store grip because I use the computer so much with the Wacom tablet and a giant stylus that any tiny pencil just hurts my hands. So I put grips on everything, brushes, just any extended drawing or painting I need to kind of, well, I don't have it on these, I guess, but because I switch brushes so much, but yeah. Well, see, I had one of those Alvin ones for like ever, and when it broke, when I finally needed to replace it, theirs is like so cheap feeling now and like not hefty. And And I just randomly grabbed, like, well, I guess I'm going to start the train of seeing which mechanical pencils I like to replace that one. And this one was the first one, and it's perfect. It's fine. It's awesome. I like the retractable end, which is why I had to replace the Alvin ones, because I bent it. So I'm like, this is cool. It's not too... I was going to go down the road of, like, trying all the different expensive ones. This one worked fine. This is awesome. 0.3 is the lead I need. And this one works great. The Graph Gear 500. See, like I was saying, I didn't try all the rest. This is literally the first after my other one that I'd used for like a decade. Actually, do I have it still? No, I don't have it up here. Anyways. But yeah, they were good. You said you were leaving. Thanks for stopping in. Interesting. I hate using my mechanical pencils. Except for any undersketch. I prefer my fountain pens. Yeah, I draw, I noodle in them forever. And I like them because I get thin and they don't smudge out when I use 0.3. And then I just render on top. But I can fill pages, I like the thin details I can get without it just smudging into nothing. It's just good for little detailed things. But yeah, I don't do big finished drawings with it. Because I don't do big finished graphite drawings, so it's all my sketchbook work. .5 is the minimal size limit. Yeah. Amazing sketches. Hey, yeah, thanks. Thanks, man. Yeah, I would love to try out a whole bunch of different types of mechanical pencils. I was actually looking at a rot ring, I don't know. They have fancy pencils. Fancy pants. The more I see on the tools you use, I want them. My wallet hates me. Dude, this is how I'm horrible with that. Yeah. I'm horrible with that. My original, the Alvin pencil and sketchbook, and then, I don't have it with me. I got these little things I draw in. I saw this Sean Andrew Murray, the concept artist guy. He had one of these and a mechanical pencil. And I had already had that mechanical pencil and used it, but it was just in my like box of old mechanical pencils. And I'm like, yes, I must have. And I started using it and then just got addicted to using it. This is when I started keeping a sketchbook kind of regular with me. Like, I already even have the pencil he uses. You see one little like video of like a dude and you're like, yes, I want to try it. I got Kim Jung Ji, awesome illustrator, uses these. I'm like, gotta have them. Jake Parker a few years ago had this and he was inking comics with it. And I was like, oh, wow, a brush pen. I had to have it. Old Red Jar Jam. I don't know, I might have had this before. But now it's attributed to that. This one. Yeah. Anyways. Yeah. I didn't buy a lot of traditional stuff for a long time, though. So I'm like, I'm digital. I'm digital. I don't need... It was like the pencil was it. The mechanical pencil is all I needed. The rest, everything else, I did digital, so... That's every comic dude's pen. That's not true, dude. The comic artists I knew personally use these constantly. And it took me a long time to try. Like, all of my friends that I knew that did comics, not all of them. Gotta take that back. But a handful of them all use like brush and pen nib with the inkwell. It's the only way. I've got another friend that uses all these Tombows for all of his comic stuff. Just only Tombows. Anyways. But yeah, it is a popular pen. That brush pen is friggin' popular. Those G-nibs are cool. I use them every now and then. They're pretty awesome. I don't like following the way that some of those dudes use it. Like, you must pull the pen like this, just so. Like, nah. Scritch, scratch. They're like, ugh. They're probably cringing if they could see. Like, oh, you're gonna break that. Did you see the way he pulled that line? Shivers. Laughed off the comic book table. Oh, I need those. Yeah, you need the G-Nib. They're cheap. This is really cheap. That's what's awesome about this, is that the nibs are cheap, whatever, and then you buy... Just a little inkwell. This stuff lasts forever. Relatively cheap. Way cheaper than buying a freaking 50 pens with it, which is what I also have. These Sable Kalinskis. These are a little more expensive, but not really. It's like $20 for this brush. That's kind of expensive, I guess. Absolutely. I want to see all that fat loot. All that art loot. It'll make me jelly and I'll be like, oh, I need to re-up and buy some more. Anytime I see someone buy new watercolors, I'm like, oh, I want more watercolors. Except I'm like, I don't have any... I've got room for 1, 2, 3, 4. I can pick 4 more colors to fit in my watercolor bin. And then I won't. I'm too lazy. There's no way I'm going to have multiple palettes sitting around that I'm just like, now I'm going to use this palette. I mean, maybe. See how I left it open for myself? Maybe. I've got enough. Learn to use what you got. you messed with your thing, so it takes a converter. I've just been filling it up with a syringe. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I've been using like a little syringe and filling up the little thing over and over again. Yeah, I just have a, I just fill this up and it, I mean, maybe it's probably a bad idea, but it's been working for like years. The way you do color is fascinating. Hey, the coolest mudkip. I was talking about this, I brought it up once before, and it's part like a hack for not being able to mix the same color twice. It's just like a local color. Usually you like, you pick a local color and then you want to like fill the spot and then like add your shadows or your highlights to it. But every time I have a hard time mixing colors, so I started doing this like splotchy mottled look, which I end up liking a lot, and I use it digitally a lot without kind of realizing, because digitally you can just pick perfect color, but I was, it was just this process of using like a mottled, just constantly changing the tones and putting it all over in splotches. So yeah, it's, I don't know what, how, that's sort of how it developed, and just kind of, I keep doing the same thing for good or bad. It's just the way I've been doing it. It's like, I haven't really thought about why I do it this way, but it's definitely helpful because I can't, I have a hard time mixing the same color twice. So you just sort of go. I bet you could get like really muddy looking stuff. I not bet, I know you can. I've done like getting really muddy looking stuff. So it's not like perfect or anything, but I just, it's definitely a thing. paintings before or after you're finished? I don't really name my paintings. The most I've had to do is like when I list them on a website or something, I'm like, oh, I gotta have a name for this. Or social media, like I gotta post this. What do I call it? So I'm guessing afterwards. I don't have a clue what I'm doing. If anybody wants to share an Instagram or anything from artwork they've been working on or whatnot, feel free. That'd be cool to check out. Writing, the naming is sometimes the best part. I am not a writer, so my naming is atrocious. I wish I had more of a writing thing. Come up with stories for stuff. Yeah, a good name can be solid. What'd you call this guy? Ben, speaking of that, how's Ben doing? Ben's doing fine. I think he's writing. I think he's working on a NaNoWriMo. Whatever. Which is cool to hear. Except kind of not, because it's a lot of pressure. Yeah, that's kind of the... little point of it, right? Gotta do the month challenges. Those are fun. I never stick to them, whatever. Just sort of, I ride the wave of inspiration, which isn't always like the smartest thing, but my other option is just playing video games, so I chase whenever I'm motivated. It's like, I'm motivated right now, do that. Hype it up, get into it. Yeah, you might drop out in 7 days, but you're hyped now. You're working today. Don't worry about it. It's like I ride that hype train. Oh, what we got? Chair, crackly chair. I don't think I'm gonna do a whole lot to this guy. With the Gouache. Oh my Gouache. I only started writing about 2 months ago. Like officially, you're like, I am now writing. I don't want to gouache that glows red. I mean, maybe. No. It's too much. Man. The red would stand out more, though. I'm afraid I'd ruin it. Before now, I've had ideas, but that was when I started writing my first story. Yeah, I have ideas for stuff, and I write them down from time to time. And then I think of maybe putting them in a story, and I'm like, oh, nope. It's just a thing I've never practiced. So, it's like, unless I'm going to start doing that. No, that doesn't look good. That's cool, man. That's awesome. You got a compelling motivation of a story to write. That's fun. So speaking of starting something new, I left the world of graphic design to jump into illustration. So far, I'm loving the adventure. Yo, that's cool. That's cool, Rico. Graphic design to illustration. Yeah, I was in graphic design at first, and then I went into animation. Not professional. This is just schooling and stuff. And got kind of graphic designy slash illustration jobs afterwards. But I've never been like a full-time freelance illustrator. I've just been like, I've worked as an illustrator, like a cartoon illustrator for a printing press, doing vector art. And then I pick up freelance stuff, but it's so small. I've never done like full-time like this illustration. I worked as a concept artist for almost a couple years, and I've been picking up concept art freelance every now and then, but it'd be cool to be a full-time freelance illustrator. I just haven't really chased that down too much. I was losing my mind on graphic design and it was draining me. Yeah, there's no getting around it. If you want to be illustrating, then you need to be illustrating. Yeah, and that's coolest. Mudkip. Having a fun idea that keeps you rolling is awesome. I love that. You can pay the bills being a full-time illustrator, and you can get... It's just when that comes up, I'm like, it's awesome. I'm an idol. You like the style and stuff. I'm just always like, well, being a full-time illustrator is awesome. I'm sure you can... I could figure it out, but just sort of... I don't know. The day job thing. You find a day job that it's like, oh, I got bills to pay, man. It's hard to jump in the full-time freelance thing. Feels scary. So I started, like, I wanted a certain type of work, and I started getting it, and I didn't like the few. I didn't like it. It wasn't paying very much. Like, I was getting fantasy freelance stuff. I got a few of them, and I'm like, this isn't what I wanted either. And it wasn't, like, I bet if I kept at it, maybe better jobs would come along, but, like, I just want to do my thing. Also, I had this weird realization a few years ago where I've got a wall full of illustrators on my, like, I got their art, like, from conventions and stuff. And I realized every single one of them on my wall is a personal project. And these are full-time, amazing illustrators. Like, oh, and they're trying to sell their personal projects. I'm like, I feel like leapfrog and just do what I want to do and see, and just, because if that's the end goal, is that even when they've hit all the main, like, big clients, they're still trying to do their own personal thing and push that. Like, like, so if I can just find a way to do the art that I want to make, just whatever it is, and be okay with whatever that is, then I've kind of, like, achieved that level already. Can I just be okay with that? Keep working? Yeah, it's partly that, but it's also like some mental gymnastics kind of stuff, because like I do have a day job where I'm like doing stuff that's not nearly as cool. So they're like, well, would you like, would you rather change your day job to do keep doing what you're doing? Or I was like, obviously. So obviously I would change that up if I could, if I had the avenue to change up the day job stuff. Japanese dad isn't happy. She thinks I'm wasting my time. However, my Mexican mom is fully supportive. Culture shock. Oh, sure. I bet there's... You hear about stuff like that? Or I hear about stuff like that when I listen to interviews of this children's book illustrator, Dan Santat. He's awesome. He does this, like... He won the Caldecott for his book. What was it called? Beakle or something? Anyways, he's got some... I don't know what exactly. An Asian heritage. I don't know what it is exactly. But there was a whole, like, podcast of just talking about, like, that. Like, the parents that aren't supportive. Very... They want him to be in something else. Want him to be a doctor or something. I bet that's tough. But then it made him, like, feel like he had to, like, prove it to him, so then he, like, kills himself working. I must make this a thing. So in a way, it benefited him in giving him, like, obscene, like, monster-level work ethic. So now I can go to my parents and be like, if you guys just weren't so supportive, it would really push me a lot more if I had more unsupportive elements in my life. hot take. The unsupportive parent is actually like coal in the engine. Pushing those folks that just super succeed. I just thought I was a bad dad. You don't want to go into art, kids. It's hot out here. And I don't care what. Go to art. Do whatever. Sure. I need to see success. It's like, well, you'll see whatever you see. I don't know. Don't have to tell you, Pops. I like something like, oh. Sorry, life isn't all you expected it to be. That sucks. Things not going how you planned. Is you new here? It's like, if you gotta be making stuff, man, there ain't no getting around it. You're like, I've got a curse, bro. I gotta be making stuff. I don't know what to tell you. That's how I'll be living on the street. Still be scratching marks into the sidewalk. Super late here. I'm gonna get some rest. Have a good rest of the stream. Absolutely. Thanks for hanging out and chatting. It's been awesome. This one actually came together pretty good. I'm gonna probably be wrapping up here in a few as well. And I don't hate it. What are you working on, Matt? Are you drawing tonight? Just got guilty enough to start on something. I've done that too. I've watched like someone else's stream going like thinking I was gonna start drawing. I'm like, no, if I didn't start now. Yesterday I got a job for some magic-y card art. Yeah, you just keep flying with the, like the little gigs. Is this another one of those? Is this one of the same? Like you just got, you just keep churning more and more. It never ends. Another thing, like with me right now, whenever I have a job that I'm like, I can't wait for it to be over with, like if they just kept trickling me stuff, I'm like, oh, I need a break. I need a me break. What, you don't want work? No, I do want work. God. I used to have a job that had like, oh, by the way, my name is Jasmine or Jazz. They called a dude, actually. It's fine. It's the other one. Man, I say dude all the time. I never know. It's, but Jazz is cool. I don't even know how to say that name. Rake. I didn't ever know how to say it anyways. I just call everybody dude. Yeah, like that. I get a brother calling you dude. I call my sister dude all the time. More like dude, chill. I ain't a dude. man. I'll say man a lot. Man, I don't know, man. Your name's fine. The username's cool. Like, what does it matter? I don't know. Man, when I go into chats, people cannot say D. They're like D. I'm like is. I should have picked something like a word that people know. Oh well, I just went with my website. Dustin Lincoln was taken, and every form of Lincoln was taken. Lincoln art, and so D Lincoln art. But man, people in chat are like, what? Other Twitch channels. I cannot say your name. D. But I'm pretty sure I'll remember Jazz. Maybe, maybe not. I'll try. Now that it's been a conversation. A lot of times people come back and I'm like, who are you? Oh shoot, you've been here for a while. Yeah, man, I get it. You get like trickle in rather. I like big if I'm gonna have a big project, I like it planned out and then I know when I'm gonna be done with all of it. And it's off my back, off my shoulders, because I like room to think about and be lazy, ultimately. I like some room to come up with my own projects that I'm not going to do. I just get overwhelmed easy. If there's too many pictures at once, I can't focus. Yeah, I definitely can't do too much. I mean, I just meant like, I like having like, okay, I'm gonna siphon off my time for someone else. Fine. What's the start date? What's the end date? I only work on one thing at a time though. Done. I want to be. I'm out for a little bit. I'm done. feel like I'll just overwork, overpaint this thing, but I think I'm gonna call this one done. If I don't win one of your skull warriors, I will buy it. I need it in my art room too. For cool chat people, I would take on, I would do a commission for about the same rate for one of those. Yeah, some people, Matt, just like a few things, like, there's been so many people that call me for this, so many, Dustin. I've had quite a few people who are like, the cat one's gone? The cat one? Oh, I would've got the cat one. And it's also, I've worked at conventions enough to know that people say stuff like that all the time just to, like, say something and get away. Like, I would've, but, oh, it's sold out. Too bad. Because then I'll restock, like, oh, let's restock. Don't worry, let's restock. Oh, I'll be back. But I get it though. People like resonate with certain images and they're like, that one was cool. I like crows. The crow thing. Crow, please, the crow one. They're like, what about the others? Nah, I don't know about that, but the crow one's cool. But yeah, I'd be down. Those things are so easy and fun for me. Like, easy in that, like, it feels. It doesn't stress me out. I could do 10 more of those things without a problem. Same with this dude. Little gnome dudes. It's like, what are they for? I don't know. Bash this guy out in like no time. Anyways, I'd be down for it. If you don't get it, and you really, really want one, I'd do a small commission. I don't know what. I don't know what I would charge for painting commission. Anyways, I like art style overall, and I wouldn't mind to own one. Well, that sounds awesome. Also, once things sell, and so those will be gone. Definitely, I don't like things disappearing. So I'm not only making prints of everything that sells, and since those are just already gone, I will probably end up making prints of those and selling like a 3-pack of prints, maybe. I was thinking of doing 3 packs of stuff, of smaller prints, same with like the Mushroom Boys or whatever those, like if I did another one I'd have 3 of those. I don't know why, I've seen it before, I've seen people do packs of like 3 and stuff. Anyways, for prints. So, anyways, I think I'm going to call this one a night. It came together. Gnome-vember is here, folks, at halfway through. All right. Maybe I won't fail a raid. I failed the last 2 raids I tried to do tonight. I'm gonna actually succeed in one. Maybe. Thanks for hanging out, Matt, Jazz, anyone else lurking. Don't be a bum. Yeah, I'll try not to be a bum. All right. One sec, let me figure this out.
Hey, Red, who should I raid? Anybody got any suggestions? I don't have too many people on that I know. Thanks, 22. Glad you dig it.